achievements and all. That's a huge thing for many people. If they're not feeling successful, they're going to be having not happy with themselves, right?
Actually, I just want to say, in your sense, self-acceptance, I think very often you give us mistakes, and this acceptance is taken as approval. That I don't approve of myself. I think that you gave up clearly in the
first part. I gave up clearly in the first part. Acceptance does not mean approval. Acceptance means first saying, yes, this is a part of me. I'm going to work on that. If you are in denial, you can never even work on that, because you're not even accepting that I am a short-tempered person. No, I'm not short-tempered person. You ask somebody, are you short? No, I'm getting angry, no, I'm not short-tempered. Actually, he's getting angry about that, isn't it? So, this total lack of self-acceptance is not there. So, when we work on all these issues, somewhere we move towards, can we help them towards having a more mental peace within themselves, right? So, today what we'll do is, we'll look at the other end of the spectrum, harmony in relationships.
I also have to ask, does self-acceptance bring in a lot of guilt?
It doesn't bring in a lot of guilt. Self-acceptance brings in a lot of peace to your in your head. you have to be your own best friend. Self-acceptance means I love myself unconditionally. Right? There are no conditions. If this happens, then I love. If that happens, I love. That should not be there. If that is not there, there's a lot of peace in the head. Once you are peaceful, you can help others also in a better way. And often what happens is we are not able to accept others in our life. For some reason or another, because we are not able to accept ourselves in the first point. No, I am not at peace with myself, so I am always in tension with others, there is no harmony with others. So self-acceptance doesn't lead to it. Self-acceptance leads to peace and accepting others more wholeheartedly. Yes, people will be like that, I have my flaws. Here I am accepting myself. I am accepting myself with all my flaws, isn't it? So when you know that, then you find it easy now. Okay, this person also is like that, what is wrong? I have my flaws, she has his flaws. So why can't we live harmoniously? Whatever areas we can work, we can work together.
So, is it that self-esteem has to be raised first before we look at harmony with others, or do they go hand in hand?
They go hand in hand.
Because a lot of times we find that these people will be counseled because of external factors, that they struggle with their self-esteem. External factors also have a lot of...
Self-esteem is affected by people around us, how they treat us.
Yes.
It originates from your childhood. Self-esteem is kind of created or destroyed in the childhood for a major reason. We can still work on those things now. There some areas we can still work on it. But the depth of having the labels in the head still carries on even when they become adults.
So isn't it that we have to deal with the external factors first, or since we don't have a control over them, can we just look at self-esteem?
We can look at self-esteem issue also. Like what part of it can't they accept themselves? Or what part of it can they take greater responsibility? Or where can we help them not to become a great, more assertive? Or can we help them not to achieve small victories and success now? So that it boosts the self-esteem. It's an upward spiral. If you can start building your self-esteem, it goes up. When the self-esteem starts deteriorating, when the person feels starting low, it's a downward spiral. When you just go on deteriorating into a bottomless pit kind of thing. So we'll take a look at what harmony in relationships mean. Harmony in relationship, it's a huge topic now. What constitutes harmony in relationship? So it would be very naive on my part to say that in the next 2 hours that I can talk to you about something and you can have harmony in your relationship. Not at all true, because it's much more complicated than that. So what I am going to do is I'm going to focus on a very narrow area within harmony in relationships, and that will be communication part of it. Like when we say a relationship is built on the four pillars of either marriage or any relationship is built on the four pillars of commitment, respect, trust and communication, right? So I am going to focus very, very narrowly on just communication part, and within communication part also I am going to focus very narrowly on how do we express affection and love to each other. In a relationship, how do we do that, and why does a person not feel fulfilled in a relationship? See, we may become cynical as we grow a little older, or we may become a little disrespectful. Now, does a person need love? At the bottom of it, everybody needs love. We feel unloved in a relationship, that starts another lack of harmony in the relationship. As an example, let me tell you. Some counselor will come and tell you that I run around the whole day doing all the work in the house, then I take it, I drop my child to the school, I come back, then I again do the household work, then I have to look after the maid, I have to do the purchases, again I have to go and pick my daughter and come back, and by the end of the day I am so exhausted. When my husband comes back, there is no word of appreciation from me. Like what she said, absolutely no word of appreciation from me. You talk to the husband on the other hand, he says, I do everything for her. I have provided everything. everything now that she asks for. I buy her gifts now whenever she needs it. I also buy gifts whenever she doesn't need it also. No, whether he buys the right gifts or wrong gifts, we don't know. But now I give her everything that she is asking for. And I give her now, like, I have taken her out on vacation whenever we want to, all that. But she doesn't feel like I am loving her at all. What's happening? What do you think is happening?
Communication.
The expectation of love for each of us is different. No, the way I like feeling loved is different from the way you will feel loved. No, you may want a particular thing. Somebody may like it, na? Or we can, on the other hand, we have also heard so many people. You would have come across friends who would say, na? You know, it's been 10 years of my marriage. My husband has not bought one thing for me. Do you hear that?
Yes.
Right? You hear from friends. What she talking about? If you ask the husband, you say, na? What is it for me to buy for? Everything is hers. Whatever I have, she can buy. I have given her the card and she will buy whatever she wants. Does she want that? Does she want now that the money is given and you buy whatever you want? What is she feeling unfulfilled about? Isn't it? There's a feeling of I'm not being loved. Isn't it? Everybody gets this feeling somewhere or another. See, it's like an emotional tank we have inside us. Even children have it. What I'm talking today may be applicable to, you know, marital counseling or premarital counseling that we do, but it applies to any relationship. But all of us have an emotional tank inside us now that needs to be filled in a particular way. You know, what is this particular way? That's what I'm going to explore. What I'll do is I'll give you 5 different ways in which we all express love or we like to be loved. There's 5 different ways in which we like to be loved. I'll explore that with you. Then we'll have an activity now where, as a counselor, you will try to find from your counseling now what is her expression of love. Right? So before we start out, I just wanted to write one thing. Write about one relationship in your life now which you would like to increase a little more harmony in that relationship. Because whatever I talk, if you can connect it to that, it will help you now, even when you do a role play of counselor. Just write one relationship, the name of the relationship. If you are married or if you have a boyfriend, girlfriend, that will be the first choice. If you are not having a partner, then write the closest relationship in your life, which where you would like to increase your harmony or better understanding of the person.
Okay.
Let's look at the, I'll be looking at 5 different ways in which people express affection to each other and which is the way I feel you need to identify for yourself. I'll ask you to rank in the order of preference, which do you think, do you know yourself well or do you know the person you have written very well that you can say, my partner, this is the way he likes to be loved, right? The first language of love or first expression of love is words of affirmation. Words of affirmation mean is, some of us are very, very oral. Oral in the sense, we are keen about this sense of the ear. So if somebody tells us that, you are good in this particular area, we need praise. We need appreciation in our life. This is an important, all of us need this. One thing I want to do is, all the 5 languages of love is something all of us will need. We need it in different proportions or we need it in different priority in our life. Same thing happens to the counselling also. Whatever I am relating to, please relate it to the counselling situation also, because that's where it really applies also. So when we say words of affirmation, some people are very keen that they want to hear. I want to hear that somebody loves me. Just giving a gift to me doesn't make. I want to hear that somebody saying that word, I love you. Or you're looking good. Or you're saying that you are done a wonder. Praise and appreciation is important for me. And when that is not coming, I always feel unfulfilled. Like what you were saying, if somebody doesn't praise you, is it deliberate? Maybe they didn't understand that this is what is your expression of love. Your expression of love is. This is your language of love. This is your first language of love. If your first language of love is words of affirmation, if you don't hear the words, you are not going to feel emotionally fulfilled at all. Right?
Let me
come. So when we say words of affirmation, there's another way of looking at words of affirmation. In a relationship, some people will say, I don't mind her telling me anything. I'll do anything she wants. If she tells it to me in the right way. How often do we hear that? I don't mind her asking me to do a job. Even children come and tell you, I don't mind you telling me, please do this, I'll do this. Please tell it to me in a can't be forced. Right? Love is always not asking, not can you do this for me? No, the person will do that for you. If you say, I just do this for me, you know, order it, the person doesn't like it. You know, slowly another this harmony is getting lost in the relationship because you do not know that for this person words matter a lot. So if somebody is there in your relationship where words matter a lot, you have to pay attention to that. If the person to whom you have written if his or her first language of love is words of affirmation, can you rethink how you are going to talk to them? Can you say can you find ways of praising them, giving the appreciation? Praising is different from flattery. Why?
Flattery is not really the reality.
Is
not genuine.
Flattery is not wholehearted. Flattery always is not sincere. Flattery is always has a purpose. Right? Whereas words of appreciation do not have a purpose. I am not appreciating you because I want something from you. Right? I am not saying something to Sindhura because I want something from Sindhura. I am just saying Sindhura just because I liked it, I told her this. Whereas flattery is always looking for something in return. Right? So how do you give words of appreciation? Keep it very simple. Even every day in the morning telling somebody that you are looking good, this dress suits you, red is your color, you look sharp in a suit, when you wear this kind of shirt, you really look good. All these things are words of appreciation. And words of appreciation also come in when the person needs encouragement. Can you be encouraging in their work? Whatever they are doing, can you say, it's a wonderful. How often do you hear always say, I've spent 2 hours cooking and everybody came and did, not one word from anybody saying, I did a good job.
It's
a thankless job. It is a thankless job because nobody is giving you the thanks. That's what you're looking for, isn't it? That I spent 2 hours in the kitchen cooking 10 dishes and everybody ate, everything is empty on the table, there is nothing left. But did anybody say that, hey, you did a good job?
Or this particular thing? I feel very happy even if that is done.
You get adjusted to that.
Yeah, we know what it feels.
The moment something's not right,
it's up. Negativity will always come. Little less of salt, a little less of something, they will make a huge scene or everybody comes to know, what happened today, this is not there. Right? So words of appreciation form a very important part in some people's life. If words of appreciation is in your thing, you need to tell somebody that. Look, if you tell me this, it will be better for me. I always feel very loud. If you just tell me some words of appreciation every day, you like to hear that every day. And when we say harmony in relationships, harmony in relationship is not created by going for an expensive vacation once in 2 years. Right? If you think that harmony in relationship is good, let us go out for 3 days to say Kodaikanal or some Ooty or some place, and you think that is the way that to build harmony in relationship, it doesn't work. Suppose you are the kind of person who is fighting here all the time, and you carry out over it, there also you are continuing the same argument, the same topic, everything is same. The dialogue is same, scenery has changed. Right? That's what I mean. And you are going on fighting so much at Kodai or Ooty, you are thinking, the fights become so intense because there is nothing else to do. Here it is, you have children, you have a family, somebody is, there is a diversion. Here, just the two of you go there and you continue the fights, when it becomes so intense, you think, why is this all hill stations are only suicide point? No, murder point. So, words of affirmation become very important. Harmony in relationship is not built by doing something once in a year or once in 2 years. It's done because we're doing something every day. Every day of our life, to our children, to people whom we love, it is some way I can think how do I feel their emotional tank. If I don't feel that emotional tank, then this is going to be empty and the person is not going to feel loved, no matter what else you do for them. Right? What else you do, let's look at any clarifications you want from
there. I have a question. This actually we should cover with side. More often learning all this, boy tell the husband about it, and the morning he starts saying, oh, this is so beautiful.
let me come to the point. What happens is, sometimes we don't express. Suppose you have these words of permission, you tell him, hey, look, I like being like this. In the beginning, it may seem artificial to you. But if that person is making a sincere effort, you have to give that person a long go. Because change always takes time. Right? And in the initial life, always look artificial, it will look what is this suddenly coming and he has never told me that I look good and suddenly he's coming.
And even the person to see,
he'll be feeling awkward. Even if the person is not used to it, like she said, if the person is not expressing their words of appreciation, now you tell them express words of appreciation, the person feels awkward, he doesn't know how to do it. So somewhere it comes with practice, this is how this person feels. And you'll still feel good. Even if you feel like this person is making an effort, you feel good, at least he said that. Isn't it? That's how you build the harmony, isn't it? That's when it starts off, in a way. Anything else?
sometimes, you know, even if you appreciate somebody, they just don't know how to take it.
They don't know how to take it. Yeah. See, that is their problem. And one more thing, I'll come to whether words of affirmation is their language of love or not, how do you? Isn't it? Some people know it doesn't matter to them. You tell them something, it will be like that.
Yeah.
Is it good? Okay. I mean, it just dismisses. It registers in their mind that this person appreciates me. Not that it doesn't register. But it is not the most important way for them to feel loved.
And also, there could be, like, you know, if I find somebody beautiful, they might not think they are beautiful.
They're not beautiful. Absolutely. So, that's always their self-image.
Yeah.
Just remind me at the end of, you finish my and then remind me now, how do we go about it? And when we talk of love in a relationship now, always remember it's about the other person, not about yourself. You might not feel like giving words of affirmation to them because you're not used to it. But if you need to build and you discover that that person's language is words of affirmation, you need to make an effort. Right? Love always takes effort. It's not something that comes easy. Right? Love always makes effort, and every relationship building is an effort is involved. So the second language of love would be quality time. What does quality time mean? All of us use this word so much, right? It's become a jargon. I want to give quality time to my children. I want to give quality time to my spouse. What does quality time mean?
The time they would want.
Beneficial.
Doing something. Whatever they would like.
Both of you enjoying it. One thing that you have to remember about quality time is undivided attention. Right? Focused, undivided attention.
Women believe that men can't multitask.
Actually, no, nobody can multitask.
They can. Women can multitask, the men can multitask. Quality time is not multitask. When you do that thing, that person does not feel that you have listened to them. You might listen to everything, see, you can give 10% attention and listen to the entire conversation, and then at the end of 10 minutes, he is giving back. No, this is what you said, this is what you said, this is what you said.
Maybe he was not reading the paper actually.
No, he is reading the paper also. He is reading the paper also. See,
maybe just trying to show that, okay, I am not.
Sometimes we are very clever, now we can pick some words, store some words, and then connect the story, and we know what is going on. Every day, the same thing goes on.
Unwinding.
No, it is an unwinding. It's a very relaxing thing for men not to read.
We don't know actually, really, it's a very
valid point. It's a very valid point. What Suresh made is a very valid point, na? That men need unwinding, not to look at a bigger picture or solve bigger problems, at least in their mind. Right? They have a solution for everything in their mind, right? Yes.
Actually, I just wanted to add to what she says. Like, earlier, my issue, the minute my husband would come, I would say, she is not studying, she is not on her diary. And he's already had that the whole day. Then now I've changed it actually. Now I don't say anything, and afterwards,
say it later.
Now there's a much, lot of difference. Because then he was coming later.
Yeah. 7 to 7:30, she will be there. So I'll go after 7:30.
Yes.
It doesn't get pushed, isn't it?
So,
you have to understand that. See, some different people need different levels of unwinding. People have already worked, they are driven in the traffic and come. You know, that is a big hazard now. If you are driven for 1.5 hours in the traffic night, you just don't want not to hear any more sound anywhere in the world. So then at the moment the child comes, you know, or the spouse comes, it really is going to irritate them and they're not going to listen now in the way. You give them a 10-minute, 15-minute break. They are also now willing to be a part of the family now and listen to you. So quality time, how you spend with persons matter, and if you can get something to do together on weekends or any other evening, you know, always involve the whole family together or the two of you together. What is of your interest? You know, go and do that. Even if one person is not interested, he is doing it because he is aware that it is important for you. You know, love is focusing on the other person, not focusing on yourself, right? So that is about quality time. Anything else about quality time you want to add? Let's look at the third one. This is something easy to understand, but difficult to understand. When we say gifts, it seems to be the easiest things to do, isn't it? But yeah, what is that? I can give you, how many husbands now give regular gifts to their wife, but still not the wife doesn't feel happy. Why? Isn't it? Sometimes you need to understand that gifting is always about focusing on other person. Right? If you are thinking, I want to give, I have seen so many people, especially the techie crowd, they love gadgets. Right? So, I want to give something to my gift. So, he brings you and comes to you now in Galaxy Note or some notebook. You are wondering, okay, he has given it to you, what do I do with this now? No, I don't even know how to use it. Will he explain how to use it? No, you learn, you can learn it on your own. Now, you are left with a gadget of 50,000 rupees or 30,000 rupees. It's expensive. First, you feel guilty about having such a big gift from him. And then you don't know how to use it. And then you are wondering, why did he give this to me? Is this what I wanted? Right? So, gifting is, if you do not put thought into the gifts, the other person is not going to give you. She or he may like gifts, but are you thinking what you have to give? Or are you just thinking about yourself? Gifting, if you are thinking, I like this and I want to gift it, you are wrong. Right? Gifting always has to be focused on the other person. Otherwise, they will not feel that this person has gifted me anything at all. And sometimes we also have this notion that if we can bring this surprise element into the gift, it will be very good. It works with children, right? You tell the child in the morning, today evening I am going to buy something, whole day he or she is excited. It works with adults also. You know, if somebody tells
also, birthdays and anniversaries, if we get a surprise gift, it works.
Yeah, it works.
But
if that doesn't
happen,
that will happen. Gifts will always work as well. And if there is a surprise element involved, if there is a surprise element involved in gifting, it is very good, provided you know now what the other person seriously wants. You know, suppose the other person has expressed to you now that this is what I like. Somewhere now in the conversation,
no surprise.
See, getting a gift on an anniversary or birthday has become common. Maybe we expect it, maybe it becomes routine. Gifting doesn't mean not only gifting on that particular day. In a relationship, gifting doesn't have to be not the IQ two times in a year, harmony doesn't get built up by doing it. So, when we say a surprise and a gift, what I am talking about is I know what this person wants very clearly. Somewhere he or she is expressed that this is what I like. He has seen something in the shop or somewhere you have seen the advertisement. This is what I like. Somewhere we keep it in the mind and then we give it as a gift to them, it works. You think now you know what the other person wants, but actually you don't know. But you think, I will surprise her with a gift. So you pack something, you buy something from the shop and give, hey, I bought something. Oh, this is a huge gift. Oh, you bought something for me. Wonderful. So this is an anxiety to hearing her. And then she removes it.
Oh.
See, it's blue. Have you ever seen me wearing blue? XXL. This is what you think I am. Thank you.